go. We've said it all this morning in our I Made. Finding the perfect gift for a friend or family member, or maybe just yourself, can be tough. You want it to be unique and cool. You want them to say, where'd you find this? One local store can do that, and it's called Frog and Toad. They are also one of the biggest supporters of local artists.
Some people may look at these old skateboards and think they're junk, but Steve Duque sees art just waiting to happen.
Well, I've always been into art, even photography. Skating has always been a part of that too. So I just wanted to kind of jump in and see what I could make myself. I mean, the art, I've always been attracted to art. Art is a huge part of my life. And I just wanted to kind of see where I could take it and see how I could develop it. And it just went from there, just kind of trusted myself.
I'm not sure if Steve is a skater first or an artist first, but his artwork stemmed for his love of skating, skateboarding. He discovered at some point in his life that when a skateboard deck is broken and smashed, it can be repurposed and made into new products and art pieces.
For Steve, his artwork has been life-changing.
Absolutely, totally. I never thought that I would be able to bring it to where it's gone now, and even how fast it's grown. It's never ending. I mean, it's just always changing, and I meet new people, just always thinking of different things. With old skateboards, I'm upcycling them into pens, keychains, jewelry such as earrings, necklaces, coasters, back scratchers.
He's been able to get his hands on a steady stream of boards.
The old skateboards either come from my personal collection, my buddies who skateboard and they donate their boards, and the skate shop where I sell my stuff.
He also takes incredible photographs, and a lot of the photography he does stems from being a skateboarder. When you're skateboarding, you're usually in an urban area in a city, mm-hmm. and you're surrounded by buildings. You've got an incredible viewpoint on the landscape of that city that you're skating in, and a lot of his pictures sort of come from that place.
I call it iPhone photography, or something along the lines of that. And it's so convenient to have your camera on you all the time. I mean, I'm constantly taking pictures. And so using applications now on my iPhone, I'm able to easily edit a photo much quicker than what it would be if I was in Photoshop. And so it's really convenient to have that instead of my big bulky DSLR camera. I guess it's like an internal feeling. It's just a feeling I get from the inside. I just kind of like a feel for it. So I always take multiple shots of, you know, different angles and stuff, but I always have that one shot where it just speaks to me, and I know that that's the shot.
Like every artist, they need the support. And lucky for Steve, he has it from Frog and Toad.
Being a part of this Frog and Toad, it's a tremendous blessing. I never thought that I'd be connected to just a location that's so in tune with the community. And they have just awesome stuff from all over Rhode Island. Just a great supporter for the arts, especially in Rhode Island and around New England, really.
And he really is just a real nice guy. Frog and Toad, located on Hope Street in Providence, they have some of the coolest and most unique gifts you will ever find. Getting something from them might make you the best gift giver ever. We're going to post a link to the store's website on ours, roadshow.com.